from the beginning of Mass, and certainly appreciate that today is a special day in the life of the diocese, and certainly throughout the world on this Mission Sunday. But in light of the second reading, I think we can appreciate our tradition when we hear of the priesthood of Aaron. Today, we celebrate that as we are all baptized as priests, prophets, and kings, and lords. So our priesthood today is that celebration of our faith, perhaps in an extra special way, the ritual and the renewal of our baptism promises all that in the heart of the Eucharist. But we are also in the line of baptism. And we don't know where he came from or where he went or often what he was doing, but he too carried the presence of God. In a sense, we can say, more out in the world. But yet, together with Aaron, two very fine images of who we are in Christ. Very devout and reverent as we gather, but also alive in the Spirit, taking us hither and yon. And so we appreciate today Mission Sunday. We give thanks to the Lord for missionaries in the classic sense who dedicate their lives on behalf of the Lord and the gospel, bringing the good news around our world, often in troubled areas, often in very volatile areas that could erupt in violence and warfare and persecution at any time. But as we sang in the responsorial song, the Lord has done good things for us. We are filled with joy. That spirit is the impulse for so many missionaries who just have that call to bring the good news to peoples that requires of them really laying down their lives and becoming one with those they evangelize and with those who also enrich their lives in many ways. And so today, as we come together at the beginning of the Mass, we have the more formal proclamation of the Synod on Synodality. That's a phrase, and it takes a little while to chew on that, to think, what is this about? But it really is at the heart of our tradition as a people of faith, as baptized Catholics, as disciples of the Lord. The Pentecost experience is before us when we consider what Pope Francis is asking of the Church. Those gathered, the 120, as we heard earlier, all disciples, Blessed Mother, the Apostles, those who had accompanied the Lord throughout his earthly ministry. And they're praying intensely for the gift of the Holy Spirit. And we know at Pentecost, the Spirit came down in the form of tongues of fire, strong driving wind, and Peter got up in the midst of everyone and spoke. That's the image of sin, synodality. Pope Francis wants the Church to gather in prayer for a number of months, leading into a year and then into a second year where there will be time to absorb all that the Spirit is speaking to the churches in that deep sense of faith. And then Pope Francis, as he does, puts together with others really a document, a statement of who we are as the people of God now in this 21st century. We hope over the course of 6 months to bring about, again, this process that will enrich us. And it will begin quietly in the background for a couple of months, preparing, again, materials and facilitators. And then in gatherings in our parishes, we hope our schools, through Catholic charities, perhaps, many who are not Catholic, but invited to speak to the Church, ministries of the Church, and then with social media, really giving people an opportunity who are not part of our congregations regularly, who might also want to speak and to enrich this whole process. Bartimaeus reminds us that our gatherings are very, very much about the people of God, about an assembly, very rich tradition of the Old Testament, Mount Sinai, dedication. from exile, we heard in today's first reading, a lot of joy associated with that, belonging to a people. Yet Bartimaeus reminds us that they're a person. And that's part of this process, where Francis is saying, you want to hear a lot of voices, maybe those that you don't normally hear. And so Bartimaeus would represent, in a, I think, a very profound way who Pope Francis is speaking about. He shall be from the side of the Lord, and he wants to get our Lord's attention. And what happens? The people gather around Jesus the throng are telling him, shut up, nobody wants to hear you. Stay on the side of the Lord. You really don't matter. And then Jesus stops and ignores them. He ignored his disciples when they children wanted them to Jesus and they were shooing them away. So he says, call him for me. And what happens? There's a whole change. All of a sudden, this throng we're trying to suppress Bartimaeus are now telling him, get up, get up. That's such an image in the scripture. Every time Jesus heals, it's rise, get up, come to full stature. So he does, and he comes to the Lord, and that dialogue is going to come. Could be asked to be my voice, what do you want me to do for you? And he wants to see, of course. And Jesus says, it's your faith, your desire for something more, for healing, to be in my presence. You are richly blessed. This sight is restored, your faith has been your salvation. And now all of a sudden, this throng of people rejecting the beggar, now are welcoming us as a community of faith to follow the Lord of the world. It's an amazing story, really, and it's not only the beggar who sees, it's now the people following Jesus who see more deeply through the eyes of faith. That's what Pope Francis is hoping for, this process, that we can be surprised by the Holy Spirit. We can at the very least, hear one another. And that's a challenge in today's world, right? We do not agree with polarization, politicization. All you have to do is push a button and look out. But that's when we're calm. When we're a community and not a crowd, there's more hope. The hope is that in dialogue with the Word of God, as this story is about, Jesus, that we can change. We can change in the sense we can listen more profoundly, and be willing to come together at a different level. So the process is a dialogue of God's Word in our hearts and minds, and then with one another in that spirit, and then bringing this together and really from across the diocese, and hopefully a very good response. Potentially thousands of responses. It will be work bringing it together into a 10-page synthesis, but what a story that it can be a blessing to understand at a deeper level who we are as the people of God, the body of Christ, in the Diocese of Jackson. So that will happen over the next 6 months, and again on Pentecost Sunday. This day, Mission Sunday, Pentecost Sunday in mind, we start off a very blessed day because it's not just the formal missionaries who are called to give thanks to the Lord. We are filled with joy for all the good things He has done for all of us. And we pray for one another that we can hear the voice of the Lord blessing us, talking to us, and inviting us from the margins onto the main street, following Him each day faithfully throughout our lives.